Our performer of the week by On Milwaukee. The best way to have like your birthday week, this is like better than your birthday week. Your birthday happens every year. You only get nominations like, well, me never, but you know, hell, not that often because getting an award is a fun thing. You decided to share that special occasion with all of you. Welcome to the stage, Mr. KJ Prodigy!
About something that happened 14 years ago. I was 6 years old, and this poem is entitled Angels on Ground Zero. I try not to press it too much. I can honestly say, I remember where I was when that trepidatious day came and flamed the eyes of vulnerable people's pupils all across the world, and particularly the so-called United States. I was 6 years old, in a white button-up and navy blue pants, our uniform in our elementary school, when Ms. James, my first grade teacher, stripped us from our seats and moved us to the carpet. She rolled out a TV on the rolling stand from a small Alwar coat hung and turned it to the news, where the news spoke of terror. Being so little, I didn't know what terror was or what it meant. Because at the time, my mind was bent on Crayola crayons, cookies, and extra large pencils, and a holy school environment. On that screen, me and my curious side classmates sat legs folded and watched white dragon airplanes crash into twin edifices like blind kamikazes. It was too loud, vibrant sounds until they crashed into the ears of those buildings, making smoke billow as Americans wept like willows, because our tree of security hadn't grown in the ground deep enough to stop this from happening, to keep those two mechanical white falcons from crashing into the ears of those buildings, killing it cataclysmically, destroying the ceilings of everyone's faces who watched, trying to block the catastrophe. Leaving so many lost of words. Their words at the time were sickened into a land of oblivion, because their throats were in a knot so tight they choked after chanting fear on the streams of their own saliva. Their esophaguses had become equivalent to what was constriction, if not stronger. They watched, we watched the man in the suit, lost of his blazer, holding a suitcase, jump out of destruction's mouth, coughing up smoke and prize of cement ashes and debris by the masses, as time stood still, like dropped and shattered our glasses, as those uniformed men and firefighters showed compassion, putting their lives on the line thinner than the skins of their teeth. I can tell that on that day, their teardrops probably tasted like ethers of arsenic fluid, because they called down the canvases of Caucasian, African, Hispanic, and Asian faces and dove into the ditches of their lips. Call it the sweet liquefaction of sadness and fear. Call it the epiphany for rectification as our country looked itself in the mirror and cried. But if those New Yorkers would have waited a second after the smoke cleared and the sirens stopped welling, they would have been able to take a big apple bite out of the sight to see halos roll out the wreckage like lost hubcaps and transform into angels on ground zero. Make some noise! You guys are awesome. Make some noise, John George Mayer. you all around.
Well, you fucking KJ Prodigy.